Ah, hooray! Okay.
How you doing?
I've never done this before. I'm looking at my screen and it says ringing for Joanna. Do you see that?
No,
Oh, okay.
don't.
But you
Yeah.
see me, I guess. Is that right? You see me? No,
No, I can't see you, just your picture.
yeah, that's what I mean. You can see my picture.
Okay.
That's good
Yeah.
enough. Okay. See, I'm trying to teach people how to use this, and I'm making a video right now. So,
Okay.
when I did a, I put conference, and it's ringing now on Joanna.
Okay.
But for you, you and I are talking.
Okay.
Okay, so, we have been having a very nice chat. You said something about dictionaries, monolingual and bilingual, and
Yes,
speed reading.
speed reading.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Let's start that right now. Let's
Okay.
talk about what are the important issues about dictionaries and speed reading.
All right, I actually didn't want to make a connection between speed reading and dictionaries. They could be two different, separate
Okay.
topics, right?
Which one do you want to start with?
Well, I can start with a speed reading, if you will.
Good. Okay. Go.
Yes, I think that from my experience, most students, are concerned with the demand of reading nowadays. There are so many things to read, and that especially on the internet, newspapers, novels, fiction, and nonfiction, that most of my students here, they are very interested in these topics. So since I am very interested as well, and I study speed reading for quite a good period of time, I've been always trying to encourage my students to learn to read faster, right? But learning to read faster does not mean that you're going to read everything with the same speed. Speed reading has a lot to do with your experience as a reader, your background knowledge, the difficulty of the material, the text that you're going to be dealing with. So there are a lot of factors involved, right? But I do think that in any way, students can learn to acquire some techniques that will enable them to read faster. In my case, for instance, I'm a great proponent of reading with your hands, using a pacer, right? I believe that
Interesting.
if you use a pacer for reading, like your hands or a pen or a pencil, you can grasp more rapidly the ideas, the main ideas in the book or the paper. And I've been doing this for about 4 and 5 years, and my reading speed has increased tremendously, right? And also, something important to be taken into account here is comprehension. As you know much better than me, there is no reading if you don't understand what you're reading, right?
I
And
agree.
I've also believe that by reading faster, you can, and using some of these techniques that I've mentioned, like using your hands and skimming, scanning, you can grasp the main idea of the text, and ultimately you can understand what you're reading better, right?
I like what
I
you pointed out. That's a very good summary. I'm looking right now at the Wikipedia article about speed reading, and they mention skimming, sub-vocalize, and
Yes.
you use the word pace. I think
Yes.
pace is a good word.
Yes. Pace is one factor. You have other factors like sub-vocalizing, or which stands for moving your lips while you're reading, right?
Right.
As we say here in Brazil, I mean, if you really read out